What's going on? Matt Savoca here from Awesomeo.com, bringing you the Week 17 Monday Night Football DraftKings Contenders video. This is Cleveland versus Pittsburgh. Cleveland already eliminated from playoff contention. The Steelers fighting for their playoff lives. They need to win, and they need Jacksonville to somehow beat the Colts in Week 18. But first, they got to take care of business against Baker Mayfield and the Browns, who certainly want to play spoilers on what is likely Ben Roethlisberger's last night at Heinz Field as the starting quarterback for the Steelers. Before we get into this one fully, go ahead and like this video, subscribe to the channel so that you always know when we're going live. You guys know what to do. And if you could give me Matt Savoca a follow on Twitter at Draftaholic, that would be much appreciated as well. We'd also like to thank our presenting sponsor, Prize Picks. Prize Picks has player props contests for all major sports and a bunch of niche sports as well. If you've got niche sport knowledge, go into Prize Picks and utilize that knowledge today. You can play power plays where you need to get everything right, or flex plays where you don't have to get every single pick right and you can still 1.5x or 2x your money. And you can get a month of Awesomeo Plus Platinum when you sign up for Prize Picks at the promo page, awesomeo.com/prizepicks-promo. That's awesomeo.com/prizepicks-promo. All right, guys, on the screen here, you see my 10 through 6 of my top plays for this Monday night game. Some surprising names here, not quite making it into the top 5, but a lot of pass catchers here, as both of these teams have rock solid projections for their running backs and not so much for their auxiliary receivers here. So Ray-Ray McCloud surprisingly showing up in 28% of our optimal lineups because of that low salary under 4,000 on DraftKings, and he's quietly had over a 10% target share over the last 6 weeks. We'll take that from a low salary player. He's getting in there as a value play. The Steelers defense nearly a third of the time in the optimal lineup here. And then Chase Claypool, who's only had 8 targets since that week 14 blunder against the Vikings. It maybe cost them a chance to get the win there. And still, he's in the optimal lineup a third of the time. And he's a big play receiver on the team. He's just not getting used as much over the last few weeks. Donovan Peoples-Jones is the big play receiver on the Cleveland side. He's had almost as many air yards as Jarvis Landry, despite having significantly less targets since Odell Beckham got traded. And then here's the biggest surprise here. Ben Roethlisberger, still a 46% chance of being in the optimal lineup, but he does not crack the top 5 on DraftKings in terms of our optimal lineup percentages. It's a little bit different on FanDuel. This is where salary really matters, but Ben Roethlisberger, only an optimal captain 6.9% of the time, and an optimal flex play another 38% of the time. He's outside the top 20 in most efficiency metrics and does not crack the top 5 for this Monday. Who does? Let's watch and find out. At number 5, it's Deontay Johnson. Deontay Johnson is a target monster for this Pittsburgh Steelers offense. He's 4th in the NFL in targets and 5th in target share. Now 16th in air yard share, indicating that he is a high volume, low average depth of target player. Still, he's been efficient even though the touchdown upside is not good on this team. They're the 28th ranked offense in PFF's offensive grades. He's 21st among receivers in yards per route run, 19th in fantasy points per route run on that high volume there. So I'm not surprised to see him scoring over 30 fantasy points in 12.7% of our simulations. And while he's scoring under 10 fantasy points in 27.5% of our simulations, he's got an encouraging 9% chance of being that optimal captain play at 10,400. The volume is high. We probably are going to see 10 targets, 9 last week, 5 the week before. But in the 6 weeks prior to that, he had had 10 or more targets every single week. He is ahead of Ben Roethlisberger, likely because of salary-based considerations. He's in the optimal lineup 47% of the time. At number 4, it's the Browns' Jarvis Landry, and absolutely the wide receiver 1 on this team since Odell Beckham was traded. You can probably project him for at a minimum 7 targets. That's what he had last week, 8 the week before that, 10 the week before that, but that's kind of a ceiling there. We have not seen him have more than 10 targets in a game this season, so I'm not surprised to see him only scoring 30 fantasy points in something like 6% of our simulations. That's a lower ceiling than Deontay Johnson below him on this optimal list, but the floor is likely a little bit higher here. Under 10 fantasy points in just 26.7% of our sims, and he's an optimal flex play a really, really solid 39% of the time. That's where I really like Landry this week on DraftKings at that flex position. The median projection of 13.5 at an 8,400 salary, that's ahead of salary-based expectations. So I'm not surprised to see Jarvis Landry as basically a coin flips chance, 49% chance of being in the optimal lineup this Monday. At number three, it's Najee Harris. And yeah, the projected volume is just too good for Najee Harris to ignore, even at 10,800. Median projection and nearly 17 DraftKings fantasy points. And you can't be surprised. He's number one among running backs in total targets, number one in weighted opportunities, number two in receptions, number one in route participation rate. And he's been efficient on that workload. He's gotten third in the NFL so far in total evaded tackles, and he's ninth in the NFL in total breakaway runs, his ability to turn a rush into 10 yards. So while the offense he's on is not efficient and the touchdown upside is lowered because that team simply does not get into the red zone or into goal line situations as much as we want, Harris is efficient enough and has the requisite volume in order to be a really, really high quality play in a single game slate. He is the optimal captain 8.3% of the time, and of course, we're seeing him in the optimal flex spot 45.9% of the time. Najee Harris has probably 20 touch, 25 opportunity upside in this game. Even though it is a strong defense, Cleveland ranks eighth in yards per carry allowed this season, Najee Harris is showing up in the optimal lineup 54% of the time. Number two, it's Baker Mayfield. And Baker Mayfield just has a salary low enough and a median projection high enough that you can consider him a value. But I don't actually think he has that high of a ceiling here. Over 20 fantasy points just once this season. I think saying that he's scoring over 30 fantasy points in nearly 12% of our simulations is honestly generous. We're probably seeing between 10 and 20 fantasy points here. So I'm not surprised to see his median projection almost smack in the middle of that at 15.8. Of course, quarterbacks, even inefficient ones like Mayfield that don't throw very often, are going to show up in the optimal lineup. But still, we're only expecting 30, maybe 32 passes in this game. And Mayfield is 21st in adjusted yards per attempt, 20th in total expected points added, 25th in total QBR. He's a meh quarterback, what can you say? But he's a quarterback nonetheless on a one-game slate. Baker Mayfield has a 56% chance of being in the optimal lineup. I think I'm going to be under the field, particularly at the captain spot, but of course, he's fine at the flex. Now, before I reveal my final play, my number one play on DraftKings for this final Monday Night Football slate of the regular season, just want to remind you guys to go ahead and like this video, to subscribe to the channel so you always know when we're going live. You guys know what to do. And if you could give me, Matt Savoca, a follow on Twitter at Draftaholic, that would be much appreciated as well. And one more shout out to our presenting sponsor, Prize Picks. So cool over there. Player props contest for all sports, major or minor. And you can go to osmo.com/prizepicks-promo to claim a month of Osmo Plus Platinum when you sign up over there today. Okay, guys. Let's get into my number one play on DraftKings for this Monday night. At number one, it's Nick Chubb, running back for the Cleveland Browns. And yes, Kareem Hunt is probably going to play in this game. He's coming into this contest with a questionable tag, and he hasn't played in a couple weeks, which has let Nick Chubb actually get more work in the receiving game. Four targets exactly in three of his last four games. Before that, his highest target total all season was three. So it may be taken away at this point from Kareem Hunt, but not surprised that we are seeing Nick Chubb with a 21.4% chance of scoring over 30 fantasy points, because he's the same old elusive Nick Chubb we've always seen since he's entered the NFL. Top 10 in breakaway run rate and top 5 in juke rate. That's evaded tackles divided by total touches. So yeah, he's scoring under 10 fantasy points in 21% of our simulations, but I really don't think that's happening here. I think 15 to 25 is the most likely range of outcomes here against a Pittsburgh defense who has struggled against the run mightily over the second half of the season. He's an optimal flex play 53% of the time, and even at 11,600 in salary, he is an optimal captain play 8.6% of the time. Nick Chubb is the top player on this Monday night slate in the optimal lineup 62% of the time. And that is gonna do it for this Week 17 Monday Night Football DraftKings Contenders video. If you're looking for the FanDuel version of this video, it's around here somewhere. Go ahead and look for it on the channel. We've got all the Week 18 content you could want at awesomeo.com. We've got Saturday slates, we've got Sunday main slates, and we've got a Sunday Night Football matchup now. We got you covered for it all. Until then, I'm Matt Savoca from awesomeo.com. We'll see you guys next time.